guys, it's Tait here for the AU Review at VANFEST Day 1. Love kick starts again. Starts again. The love kick starts again. Hey, Example. How you doing?
I'm good, yeah.
Yeah?
You're really good.
We're freezing our asses off.
They didn't tell me it was going to be like this when I saw the brochure for Australia. it's definitely the coldest I've ever been in this country.
Oh yeah, aren't you Brizzy based now?
Yeah, I haven't got an Aussie citizenship, but I'm living in Brisbane. Mm-hmm. Back and forth between here and the UK because I've still got loads of gigs back in the UK. But my wife and kids are up in Brisbane now.
Oh, lovely, I'm a Brizzy girl myself. Love
yeah,
it there.
The best, yeah. The best.
I want to find out, when did you start DJing and producing? Example.
Well, it all kind of started really with rapping.
Yeah.
So it started with me rapping in a playground on pirate radio stations back in the UK. And then I made more of a transition into hip-hop. And then I started singing, making up as I go along. Started writing songs rather than just rapping.
Yeah.
Not the rapping isn't writing songs, but you know, I started writing choruses and writing full-blown songs. And then I started producing. And
it just naturally evolved from there. But you did a little bit of, like, you were a voiceover artist and an editor at Comedy Central and MTV and things, I read, correct?
Wow, you've been on Wikipedia or?
I've been on the internet. I've at least read a lot of interviews about you. Is that a lie?
I've done all sorts. Stand-up comedy, mm-hmm. editing. I've been around for a while, you know.
But I think we're sticking
Maybe
with rapping for now.
I actually am.
I think you are. Cool. You met, and then you met Aaron.
Yes.
Yeah, and you now have two children. Mm. How has fatherhood changed your music career?
Everything's gone downhill.
Beg to differ.
In 2014, I was playing arenas, and the venues got smaller the more I fell in love. I think what happened is...
The body life diminished.
All of my biggest hits, like back in like 2011 and 12, were all written about my ex.
Yeah.
And I think maybe a lot of people found a lot of joy in my sadness, you know? It was definitely relatable and it kind of suited the music, you know? But, and then I kind of got married and then I think my musical output for 3 or 4 years wasn't all that.
Okay.
I seem to be back on track in the last 2 years. I feel like the music I've put out in the last few years... Since I left the major label system and I went independent, set up my own record label.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm back on track now.
You're back on track and you released Bangers and Ballads last year.
Yeah, Bangers and Ballads was kind of like a mixtape of just songs that I'd sat on for like a year that I was frustrated that the record label didn't want to put out. So as soon as I left the record label, I was like, I'm going to stick these songs out.
Yeah.
They all did really well. And then...
Bit of a fuck you guys.
Yeah. And then I did a good collab with Jaws last year in The Zone, which did really well for me. Did a song with a guy called Darksea, who's like big in the bassline scene.
Okay.
That's done really well. And then my latest single, All Night, with me and Aaron dancing in our living room.
I love that home video.
Yeah, it's how do you follow it up now? Because I can't just put Aaron in every video in her undies. Even though...
I don't think the internet would be mad.
I think if I put the next video up and it didn't have her, all the comments on YouTube would be like,
where's Aaron?
Where's his wife? I don't want to see this guy. I've got another 3 or 4 singles coming out this year.
Oh, exciting. And what else, what else can we expect from you very soon?
Do you know what? I think I used to overthink everything too much.
Yeah.
I'm kind of enjoying not thinking about anything too much at the moment.
Yeah.
I'm kind of just having fun in the studio rather than, you know, before when you're signed to a major label, sometimes it's like, this song needs to be on radio, this song needs to be in the charts, blah, 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 and it sort of gets in your head. And I've made a real conscious effort in the last few years to just write songs for me.
Cool.
And hopefully, you know, fans like those. Seems to be working.
Yeah.
And I'm just going to literally have fun. I'm back in living in Oz now. I've got about another 12 gigs booked already for the end of the year all across Australia.
Yeah.
I'm even going to like Tasmania and stuff like that.
No one goes to Tasmania.
And then I'm back and forth all summer. So I've got like UK summer. Starting May through to September, I've got like 30 gigs across Europe.
Holy crap, that's a lot of flying.
I basically commute. You know when people moan about their commute and it's like 2 hours? My commute's 22 hours.
Fuck that, man. Oh my God. Yeah. Well, Example, thank you so much for catching up with us. I really appreciate the chat.
Thank you. Enjoy the show.